person that you worship, or you're loving. That becomes a worship. Right? When you look into the eyes, and in reality, you're seeing yourself.
You are right about the love, because the truth is I could not have salam without muhabbat. I could never have it.
Understand.
It's, it goes hand in hand.
Understand though. The Holy Prophet said, a man came up to him and said, Ya Rasulullah, I love you. What was his reply? Prepare yourself for hardship. He didn't say prepare yourself for that nice cotton wool feeling, that nice touchy-feely kind of thing. He says prepare yourself for hardship. And the way of love, as is explained by so many saints and so many poets, saints, it is like that moth that runs to the lamp, to the fire, and he extinguishes, he kills himself. La ilaha illallah. Who is declaring lordship to Allah? Shaitan? Never. In Christianity, it's different. You're still struggling with dualism. Then it got more complicated with the Trinity. In Islam, it is ahad. It's oneness, one. There is no antithesis. There is no, this is Allah and this is the devil. They're fighting with each other. In reality, this is not what exists. Light or darkness. Would darkness exist without the light? No. So it is one again. But the whole aim of those who have been created to know him, because he has created mankind, not angels to know him, man. It says, be zero, suffer, be nothing, enter into my oceans. You come zero, I will be one. Allah is Ahad. Make yourself another zero when I've made you into 10. You will be 100. You make another zero, you will be 1,000. Continuously. So now, worshipping Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he deserves to be worshipped. How are you going to worship him? And he has said in the Quran al-Karim, I created the ins and the jinns, mankind and the jinns, only to know me and to worship me. You cannot worship Allah if you don't know him. You cannot. It'll only be something that you imagine, something that you think. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Surah Al-Ikhlas, that is one third of the Quran, that Allah is saying, the Holy Prophet is saying, recite Ikhlas 3 times, is as if you made 1 hatim of the Quran. Kul huwa Allahu ahad, bismillah ar-Rahman. Kul huwa Allahu ahad, Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. After Allah describing himself for us to understand, Allah himself is saying, whatever that you think of me, I'm far away from. Allahu Akbar. And yet Allah is saying, know me. The secret I put in you. Not in angels, not in the jinns, in reality, not in the animals, not in the other creatures, in mankind, because we have been created in Ahsani Taqwil, the most perfect form. How are we going to learn this? Holy Prophet taught us this. And he has brought that teachings of tasawwuf to some who are ready, who are able to understand, and they are ready. This is At the same time, we're saying, of course it's not fair. It is not. And it'll be tyranny if I were to open it up to everyone. Because if people are not going to understand it, then it's my fault if I open it up to people who cannot understand it. There's a certain readiness which I have to gauge a little bit here and there. I'm asking support from my Shaykh. Then it is easy to give. Whatever is there, you'll be able to understand it. Now, so our worship now, before worshipping, to know. How are we going to know Allah? The one who knows himself knows his law. So the teachings, especially of the Naqshbandi order, it is to know yourself. Following that shaykh, the way that the Sahabi Kiram followed the Holy Prophet والسلام, according to Sunnah. That they say, we disappear into your oceans, Ya Rasulullah. May my children be sacrificed. May my parents be sacrificed. May I be sacrificed. May I disappear into your oceans. That the man who said, I love you, Ya Rasulullah. And he said, prepare yourself for Hajj. And he had 124,000 companions that showed us the way, each according to their level. And the level of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, the whirling dervishes from Hazrat Rumi, Qadasullah Asir, where is that practice of turning and remembering Allah coming from? It is not, as they say, he is walking in the marketplace and he heard some goldsmith hitting and that he fell into a trance. The same way that they say Islam was founded by a shepherd in the cave and he heard voices and he came out and he said, the angel came to me to spread Islam. They tell our stories. One day, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, he gave away all of his possessions. But understand this, he gave away all of his possessions to the poor. And he came to the Prophet, he even gave his clothes. And he was wearing the date palm leaves, the date leaves, he's tying around his waist. Act like a skirt cover. And the Prophet saw him and started smiling from ear to ear. So beautifully he was smiling. He says, Ya Abu Bakr, he said, in your honor today, all the angels in paradise, they are dressed like you. When he heard that, that is when Hal came to him. Because now he's no longer there. This is Asfala Safidin. This world is the lowest of the low. He fell into the trance and he started working. And the Prophet says, what did you leave for your wife and for your children, for your family, Abu Bakr? Understand how he answered. What did he say? I love them, Allah and His Prophet. What does that mean? That means that he owns Allah and His Prophet. Not anyone can make that claim. You understand? The same way, when the Holy Prophet ﷺ passed, and there was so much confusion going on, and people, they were munafiqs, they were hypocrites, who wanted to take advantage of that situation, and they said, Muhammad is dead. And these are the ones, understand now, these are the same Sahabis who witnessed untold miracles from the Prophet, who saw the splitting of the moon, you understand? Not the splitting of the sea, the splitting of the moon. That saw the sun descend on his right hand and the moon on his left. When they came to offer him everything, but leave Islam, he says, even if I have the sun in my hand and the moon in the other, I will not leave this world. The one who saw trees uproot themselves, crawling to him, to kiss his feet and crawling back. animals coming to speak in perfect Arabic, declaring his oneness. That when his uncle Abu Jahil came with pebbles in his hand, who hated him, his own family, put it behind his back and says, if you are a prophet, tell me what I have in my hand. Insulting the prophet as if he is just like a magician, a conjurer. And the prophet smiled and said, Ya Abu Jahil, open your hands and listen to what the stones have to say. He opened his hands and the stones were saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu. He dropped that and he says, you are a great magician. They witnessed all of this. They witnessed water coming out from his fingers, correct? They witnessed a bowl of food that was not even going to be sufficient for one person, feed hundreds. Muslims, they don't talk about the miracles of the Prophet ﷺ. And the greatest miracle, one of the greatest, of the Mi'raj. Understanding all of that, and the munafiqs, the hypocrites, who listen to his assembly, and they whisper to each other, and they poke fun at him. And later, it caused so much confusion, they said he's dead, he was gone. And majority of the Arabs, that time they betrayed him too, they went back to their unjust practices. There were people who were burying their daughters in the hot sand. And what did Hazrat Umar said? Anyone who says that Muhammad is dead, I'm going to kill him. But understand what he means when he says that. And what did Abu Bakr say? Those who worship Muhammad know that Muhammad is dead. Those who worship Allah know that Allah is high and qayyum. Who worship Muhammad? Did anyone? From that time until today is one of the other miracles of the Prophet. No one worshipped him. No one has ever elevated him to the rank of a deity. He is a creature. The most beloved one, the reason of all creation. Yes. But he said, those who worship Muhammad know that Muhammad is there. Those who worship Allah know that he is higher than Allah. You say, those who don't worship Muhammad know that he is alive. Mm-hmm. You understand? We are Ahli Sunnat, we are Ahli Tariqah. We know that the Prophet ﷺ is Hazir and Nazir. We know that the Prophet ﷺ, in the ayat of Laqad Ja'akum, Allah is saying, he is amongst you, he is inside of you. So we worship. We worship. But the Prophet said, your worship is a mi'raj. Worship for a believer, it is a mi'raj. It is the ascension to the divine soul. Inshallah, one day. Yeah.
Inshallah.
We ask ourselves too, why? Why? Why do we want? If we get peace too, what are we going to do with that peace? Of course, you had a continuation. Say, I want to be a good one. Yes. But this is what, especially in this tariqah, we are pushing. You ask yourself again and again and again. This is tafakkur. That 1 hour of meditation, tafakkur, it is better than 70 years of worship. So we pray. Now you're going to look at it properly. What did we pray for? Where was my heart? Who was watching? Why am I doing that? You ask. The way that the angels are going to ask us in the day of judgment. Here, in this world. So it's not too much for everyone. So you say, yeah, just do it. Why are you making such a big deal about it? Just do it and you're okay. Allah has given us intelligence. And Allah has given us the intelligence that if we're to use it, it will exceed the intelligence of the angels. Because the angels' intelligence, they cannot know Allah. They cannot. But the intelligence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us to the representatives of Allah, to Khalifatullah, we're able to reach to them. And that is the reason of our creation. Gandhi, may it be accepted,
Amen.
Our worship
Amen.
And our intentions. Gandhi.